everyone, welcome back to our channel, and this is the Chaotic Show.
Anyway, tulisa manga body count ya wanawake.
3 maximum. 3 maximum.
Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. My name is Latifa Tago and my girl
Wanjiko Stacy,
and this is the Chaotic Show. So on today's episode, this is like our second episode, and on today's episode we came up with questions. So we came up with questions we feel they are like a turn off.
Yeah.
And these questions are notorious from guys who are, I think, hitting on you, you know, they're trying to, you know, tell you they like you and all that. So, okay, so it's like you're in the talking stage most of the time.
Yeah.
So, yeah, so we feel like there's a few questions that are really annoying. Like, once they ask you this question, you're like, no, please. You even blue tick them, right?
Just
so, yeah, so yeah, they are like blue tick worthy questions.
Mm-hmm.
It's, yeah, you can say that, right?
Yeah, blue tick, like, what? Bro, I'll blue tick you if you ask me those
great
questions.
Yeah,
they're like just
so on the list. We have our first question is, when am I seeing you?
Hey. Like, why would you ask such a question at you? When am I seeing you? I think what you should do, what they should do, like those suitors, they should like try and plan something, you know, like maybe tell you, be ready by 8, let's go have dinner, you understand? Exactly. Instead of asking you at, when am I seeing you? Like, bro.
It is a very bare thing. It's like a minimum effort.
Yeah.
There's nothing you know, I think I even posted about it the other day. Like, put in some effort. If you're like, you know, you're interested in me, set up something, like plan something for me. If it's tell me, do this, can we go for lunch tomorrow, you know, can we do dinner, you know,
plan
how's
something.
Your schedule,
plan something.
But
make,
I think
an effort.
It's good to, he should ask your schedule, because also you can't just
first.
Plan,
yeah,
you
yeah,
know.
Yeah.
So he can be like, you know, what does your schedule look like tomorrow, this coming week?
Yeah.
You know, then you tell him, then you
when
know.
When are you free?
Exactly.
Like,
when are you free?
When are you available?
Yeah.
You know?
So, and then from there, there's a follow-up. Mm-hmm. Like, you know what? Let's do dinner.
Yeah.
Tomorrow or something like
or
that.
Or maybe you can pack a bag or two and meet at the airport.
Well, I feel like that one is better if you guys are already dating.
Oh, yeah?
This is someone who's hitting on you.
Someone who's hitting
so
on
you. So, he's... He is,
oh yeah, you're actually right, but no, but still, it's the effort that counts, you understand?
Okay, yeah,
it's the effort, it's not about like a tea. Okay, let's, it's the thought, not even the effort, it's the thought, like,
yeah.
if you tell me like at least you're including me in your plan,
in your
you're not
plan.
Like telling me at
okay tea. Maybe you say how's your weekend? I'm going maybe to, you know, Zanzibar, whatever, or maybe I'm going on a trip. Are you open, you know, to go with me? But you see, that's very tricky, because if you're still hitting on me, I'm not sure I'd be comfortable to join you on a trip
somewhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you see, okay, the whole
point.
You never
know. You never know. It's, for me, it's just the thought.
The thought
of it. It's not really.
Okay.
About,
let's assume it's like it's not your first, like your first date. You guys have gone on other dates, and maybe this is like maybe a month in.
Yeah.
Then it's like, okay, now
interacting after you've interacted.
After you've interacted,
you've known each other.
Me, yeah.
You like, you know, you like. He knows like what you like and whatnot.
Yeah, yeah.
So I think,
because you
I
see,
think,
this
I
guys,
it's a question
let me tell
you, can
you,
ask.
You see, when am I seeing you? It's not only from people who are hitting on you at fresh. Even people who you're into the relationship, like maybe even 3 months gone,
they still
and
ask
this,
you
this
when am
the,
I seeing you.
The same like, person will be like, when am I seeing you? When are we seeing? When am I seeing? No, seriously, when are we seeing? That's how it's said. When am I seeing you? How am I seeing you? So now, let me tell you. Can I tell you? Okay, on that note, can I tell you? There is this question that I feel like it's a follow-up. come to my house?
When will you come to my house?
Well, can you come over?
Can you?
You know?
And most of those questions,
it's like
abnormally.
Let me tell you, like, you know why nimezi fatanisha? Because after when am I seeing you, the next question is normally, come to my house.
When will you come?
Come to my house. No, you know,
it's
no.
Literally,
you either you blue tick or you just say we'll plan. Then the person says, "This is a whole chat I'm talking about. It's not a random thing. It's a chat.
Yeah.
Like hi, when am I seeing you?
Yeah.
Then it's like we'll plan. Yeah. Obviously, maybe if you are like you don't want to be rude. As the girl, you'll be like, you want to respond. So you'll be like, let's plan.
Let's plan.
They're about like. Come to my house.
Come
then
over.
We plan and go. You know. Then what will you say?
When they tell you
on the chat, like, what will you say? What will be your response?
When they tell me to come over to their house, I'll tell them. I'm not living in a tree. I have a house of myself.
You say you don't.
Most of the
you
times,
have
I,
a house, right?
Yeah. Most of the times, I say that. Like, I have a house. What do you mean? I come over to your house? Like, bro, what are we doing? If you were to go out, make a date, plan something.
Let's go. Can I respond to you?
Yeah.
Why are you acting like childish? Are you a baby?
Oh yes, right now I'm a baby.
Why don't you treat
me like a baby right now?
Are you a baby?
Yes, I'm a baby.
So yeah, this is a whole chat. That's what I said. Like, you know.
Let me tell you, these are some of the questions that guys ask like on the first date. And I don't know why.
First date?
Yes, first date. You've never met somebody who's asking you what's your body count? Me, I've met. Like, not one or two, like, but I've met people who are asking me like, what's your
body count?
I know
it's an actual question,
but most of the time I've gotten
like, how many boyfriends, you know, have you had?
This is the same thing.
It's not.
It is. Body count. It's the same thing. But let me tell you. Let me tell you. You know why it's.
You know there is one nightstand.
It's almost the same thing because.
It's not at all. There is one nightstand. You know. And then there is relationships. So, me, I've been asked about relationships. And body count includes even those that were not relationships.
Anyway, Tulisa Manga, body count ya wanawa.
Three! Maximum! Maximum.
Atakama, you've passed that, it doesn't matter.
It's
maximum.
So, well, me but don't go two.
Nico one.
The third one will be my husband. So,
you are a stranger.
I don't know you. So, I think another annoying thing, and I think 99. Send me your photos.
Your sexy photos.
Other than the ones I'm seeing or I've seen on your Instagram, for my eyes only.
Just suggesting. Send me your nudes.
Like, you know, that's literally. What is it called? That's upgraded way of asking for nudes.
It's just sugarcoating that whole thing.
Exactly.
And telling
so either sometimes it's not even nude. Sometimes he just wants other photos, but he wants. Not news.
Why would you
be sexy? You can be sexy, you know, in clothes
and not naked.
Yeah,
you but can. You know what they mean.
Of course, sexy. But no, see, you're innocent. You're just sending.
I'm naive. I don't know.
You're just sending your sexy photos in clothes, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm like, once I see, we've just chatted, right? Maybe I gave you my number yesterday. Then today we're texting, and then you're telling me. Send me your photos.
Most of the
Lunatic.
Time when they send that, I feel like they want to confirm who they met last night.
Especially if we met, like
we just met.
You know,
yeah.
It's not like someone who gave you my number. No, like we met like this. I gave you my number.
Yeah.
Then the next day you're like, send me your photos.
I don't respond.
Oh my god. Or there's this other thing. Your girlfriend or just a girl you know will tell you. Babe, send me your photos. I want to show someone.
Hey.
I do not like
that. That one for me is party over. What the hell?
You know, before, like a few years back, I felt like it's an innocent thing.
Yeah.
But then as you go, you realize it's not innocent.
Someone is selling you out.
It's
literally.
Not innocent because the moment you sent your pictures, then there's you get like maybe a text from someone or something, then I'm like, hey, you know, what's up, how are you? Then I'd like to meet you. From then you meet the person, he's not cheating you like it's like he's hitting on you. Yeah. No, he's cheating you like you're supposed to know what's happening. And then you're there like,
you're so innocent.
Okay, well, you know, you think you're a date. You're not on a date.
You are on another agenda. There's another hidden agenda.
From that time, I realized, be careful. You just don't send around your photos like that.
Because let me tell you, when they send to that person, they'll send to like 10 people.
Exactly. Maybe not, like, they even send like to groups.
You. You hey, understand? Then they start like
groups.
Maybe they start asking, do you know this girl? Do you know this girl?
So they start evaluating you. I do not.
Okay, I think the... when a guy wants to take you out, mm-hmm. and then they ask you whom you're with,
no, you know, what happened? Oh, they want to take you out.
Yeah,
and then
and you know, like it's somebody you've just met, mm-hmm. and then they tell you they want to take you out. No, you for you you can't go like alone. You understand? Mm-hmm. It's your first, maybe okay. Let's say even the second time.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, me personally, you invite me out and you've just met like once. Now this is the second time. I'm sure the first time when you met me, I was with my friends.
Mm.
So definitely even the second time you invite me, I will have to come with my friends for my own security.
Well,
not to go for your own security. Well, for my own security, because I don't know your intentions. I don't know what you want. You understand? And then it's going to be boring.
Okay.
Hanging out okay. just the two of us.
What I think is this... If he has called you to like on a date, maybe in a restaurant or something, you should go alone.
Okay, honestly. If it's a date, I don't go overboard, of course.
Yeah.
It can maybe be one friend or maximum two friends. You understand? Like honestly, that's okay. You know, it's
okay.
Like,
let's be clear. If it's clubbing, but if it's on a like on a date,
no,
restaurant,
if it's on a date, it's okay.
Go alone.
Because normally you'll just like pick me up, drop me up.
Yeah.
Period.
Yeah.
But don't start telling me until you go to my house.
No, there is this. I don't know if it's my last question. No, it's not. I don't think I'm okay with. Tell me about your ex.
Yeah.
I don't think we even you
be,
if you have an ex, don't tell me about
we
them.
Shouldn't be discussing
like,
about
feel,
your ex.
I don't feel comfortable talking about our exes. Either
that's the past.
If you're the person, I can't even ask you about your ex.
No.
Like I don't feel comfortable talking about you
yeah,
know someone who's
like,
not there. Like let's
that's
just
the past.
Not,
that's the past.
You know, let's
so,
just
no.
Not.
Like what is the reason? Like what? If I tell you about my ex, are you going to start behaving like how he was behaving? Amma, you start treating me the
and
way
you know,
he was treating me.
Like, how, you know, how
Amma, are you gonna judge? Are you gonna like
judge you
judge
from
me
what happened?
From what happened, or
yeah.
are you gonna like treat me the way he treated me? You understand? Like it's a new page. Let's open a new page. Start
and forget
afresh,
about the
and
past.
Forget about exes, unless your ex is also like still on your case. If your ex is still on your case, me, I'm
then
not
you have
there. I have to like back off.
Okay, but
then
yeah, if your ex is still on your case, you have to let the
yeah.
other person know because
yeah.
it's tricky.
Yeah,
it's very tricky. If unless you have like a baby mama or baby daddy, then you're supposed to mention. But I think someone you've cut
yeah,
off
that's crazy,
and everything,
crazy exes.
You should not
yeah.
talk about it, right?
Yeah.
And then there's this other thing. Tell me what you like in a man. Oh my god. Already I don't like that. Already. I don't like the fact that you've asked me that question. Because now...
You don't have confidence in yourself.
Not
like,
even that. So you can start acting like that. Like the way I
they
want.
They will start acting like that for like the first few weeks. And then now...
Weeks.
Oh, it's days?
Days. 30 weeks.
And
days.
Then later on, somebody has changed. And you know... As us as women, we realize, like we notice the slightest change,
yeah.
like a man that a man goes, will,
we notice,
you know, like, ati, achatuni cheke because no, it can't be me.
Like that one, we don't even need to discuss it. Just don't ask me what I like in a man. You just be yourself, your best self, and juice, you know, sell yourself.
Kizuri chaji.
Chajuza. Right?
Yeah.
You don't need a more Kenya.
Yeah.
So anyway.
You don't need me to write you a list.
No.
For you to know what I like in a man. Like, give me you as you. Then I will know if I will take it or I will pass.
Right.
You understand? Same as me. Me, I'll give you the real me, like me as I am. So it's for you to decide whether it's...
You're taking it or not.
If, or it's a pass. You understand? Period. Instead of kushina to me... Semezana, pa, you know, because when you try to
me, I feel because what I feel is this: the moment you see someone, you already know if you like them or you don't.
Yeah.
If not, what happens? Some people they grow in you.
Yeah,
some
that's
people
true.
Grow in
you. Might not
you
like them
at first, then they start growing on you. Like you're like, hey, wow! You wake up one day, like, oh my god, I'm in love. You know. And most of the time, oh god, I can just leave that one alone. That's topic for another day.
It's personal.
That's personal. That's topic for another day. So, are you okay with being asked how old are you?
I don't know. Sometimes yes, sometimes no. I think it depends with the person who's asking. I don't know. I feel like if you're an older guy, you shouldn't be asking me such a question. Not older, like if you're a mature man, I don't think you should ask me how old I am.
Mubaba, you mean? honestly, for me, I feel it's like asking my name. So I feel like I can just answer you straight up. I don't, or maybe it's because I've not reached a point where I feel some type of way
like
about
insecure
my
with your
age. Yeah, but
A woman never tells her real age. I mean, if you ask me right now, I'm 21.
Hey, me too. I didn't know how to say my real age. Okay, I'm 21.
Forever 21.
Okay, fine. No, I've learned, teacher. I've learned. Hey, oh yeah. So guys, I think my last turn of question will be, what turns you on? Yes, you're asking me what turns me on, and it's a turn off question. Like the question itself is a turn off. Imagine. So, I don't know, what do you think?
I think it's not.
Mm-hmm.
I think he's trying to communicate with you so that you can enjoy your sex life. So I don't think it should be a turn off. Okay, for me it's not a turn off because for me to enjoy my sex life,
yeah,
I need to communicate. And the fact that you will ask me what turns me on, I think that's a way to start that conversation.
Okay.
And I tell you how I like it and you tell me as well how you like it. For us to enjoy our sex life. That's what I think.
Well, you might have changed my mind.
Oh, yeah?
But, I don't know. Is it because... I don't know if it's because I feel shy when I'm asked that question. I don't know.
It's either you feel shy or you still don't know what turns you
on. Okay, maybe. I don't know.
Or you're not
so
sure.
You know what I prefer? Like, I don't know. Just work your magic.
No.
Like,
men cannot work their magic like that and they impress you. You need to communicate. You need to tell them how you like it. You need to tell them how to do it or whatever to hit the tempo.
I feel like it's the same question as what is the most craziest thing you've ever done, you know, in your sex life. So, I'm like...
What's the most craziest
thing? I've not...
Okay, now that also made on like that question because... Mm-hmm. To me, crazy might not be crazy to you, so I might be doing the bare minimum.
Well, anyway, so that's it from me, guys. But I have a question for Stacy. Stacy,
please do you have sex?
That's another question I feel like girls shy away
Please,
from.
Please do not
but
ask
yeah,
me that
not
question.
Not even girls, I think even guys. Like,
yeah.
For
they just lie.
Like, well, last time you have lying. Sex, they're like, you know, January!
I think one
I can't remember.
I think two. I don't, I'm not even sure, you know.
What? It's been long. You know, like, there's always something.
There's always a funny answer.
There's always a. I feel like. no one is ever truthful.
No, nobody. If you had sex yesterday, you just met someone and you just had sex like 2 hours ago, I don't think he will tell you, just 2 hours before I left the house.
I don't think, you know? So. I feel like it's one question nobody answers truthfully. I just feel like that.
So that's an
anyway, advantage. Our opinion.
Yeah.
Please don't come after us. It's our opinion.
But you can still drop us
comments and you tell us any questions.
Yeah, you can ask any question down there on the comments.
Or you tell us the question someone has asked you and you feel they need to.
It was a turn off.
So if we get so many questions, we can do a part two, right?
Yeah.
So anyway.
And give our reviews or something.
So yeah. We're done, right?
Yeah, I think that's it. So guys, we've come to the end of our show. This is your girl Stacy Dash. You can follow me on Instagram at Stacy Dash and my girl
Latifa Tago. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video. This is the chaotic show. Bye, besties.